Hello! In this video, we're going to take a look at how to use acoustic kits for Stylus RMX. We'll load up an instance of Stylus, get to the browser. Now here, we're going to go on to the user libraries, and then from there, we'll select acoustic kits. Alphabetically, it's at the top. You may have other libraries in here, but we'll select acoustic kits. And you'll notice we've got a lot of kicks, we've got a lot of snares, but what I tend to do is I start with the general MIDI kits. You'll see you still have a lot of choices here. There's a number of different styles. There's a funky set, there's a general set, a heavy set, a light set, and a tight set. And for each of these sets, you have different mic choices. For instance, if we choose this tight set and we go with the close mic, we can try a little kick and snare pattern. Or we can try a room setting. This is the same drums, except we've added the overhead mics. Or we can have the room mics added with not so much of the close mics. Again, it's the same drums, that's the rock mix. Or we can try the caveman, which is only the room mics with some reverb and a little bit of compression thrown on. So you can see what the different mic mixes do. It's the same drums, it's just different mixes. This way you don't have to mix them, we've done that part for you. Now, one thing about this is you're not limited even in these general MIDI kits to just the kicks and snares at the bottom of the keyboard. We've also included a lot of extra kicks and a lot of extra snares in each of these general MIDI kits. Here are the ones we just heard. But then we've also got this. Or we've got this. Or this. Or this. And then we've got even more snares after that. And of course all the combinations with the kicks and snares. And again, this is all just from the general MIDI tight kit and just the caveman mix. We've got all the other mix settings for this as well. We're listening to the caveman mix right now. But remember, these same sounds are available in a rock mix, or more of a room sound, or a close mic. So drums and acoustic kits can cover all styles, from country to jazz to hard rock to whatever. And if that's not enough, don't forget you've got the choices for all these other drums up here with the individual sets. With the snare drums, for instance, we recorded 31 different snare drums, each of those with the four different mic mixes. That's 124 different snare drum sounds. Anyway, let's go back to our beat here. We've got the kick and snare going. But now I want to add hi-hat, so let's put that in. You know, that's not quite the sound that I'm looking for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the hi-hat menu. Well, actually, I'm going to go add another channel. You could add another instance, or in this case, I'm going to stick in this multi and just add another sound through there. Go to user libraries, acoustic kits, go to hi-hat. Caveman might be a little heavy. We got five different hi-hats to choose from. That's the one I like right there. Hi-hats are kind of a personal thing, but this is the kind of tone I think. So I'm going to select. Yeah, I think open just that amount is just kind of that sloppy rock and roll feel that I want. Yeah, that's it. So now, let's go back to MIDI channel 1, where we have our general MIDI kit. See what else we might want to add. We could add tambourine, or metals, or cowbell. I don't know that it needs that. The one thing I do think I'm going to add, though, is a crash cymbal. I'm going to put that one in there. Cool. So now we've got a beat going. So let's add a guitar part. I'll put that on channel 5, kind of at random. We'll use a guitar from, of all things, Guitars by Sampleholics. you know what? I've got a better idea. Let's load one through a preset. I'm going to choose Dirty Strat. That'll work. Okay, so let's put that with some drums. Okay. Okay, you know what? Let's go ahead and add a bass as well while we're here. I'll do that through a preset as well. Let's take rock bass. Yeah, that'll work. It feels a little interesting to do all your mixing inside Stylus, but there you go. Anyway, the reason why I did this is I'm going to show you something with this guitar part that we pulled up. What it is just an ordinary Stratocaster guitar, but Stylus has all these effects. I mean, what we're hearing again is this. But if I take off these effects, then it's just a Strat running straight into the board. So really, these effects with Stylus are where a lot of this magic happens. They have not only delays and reverbs, but they have these guitar amps. So what if we put one of those guitar amps onto our drums? Let's go back to our mixer. Okay, here's the drums by themselves again. Now I'm going to go to this channel one, which is where my general MIDI stuff is. That's where my kick and snare are. And I'm going to go to this effects tab, and I'm just going to add a guitar amp. Pretty cool, huh? Let's do the same thing on our hi-hat. Dirty it up a little bit. But we don't have to stop there. I'm gonna go back to the kick and snare, and I'm gonna add, let's add a phaser. See what that sounds like. Now let's go to the hi-hat and let's add a phaser, or no, you know what? Let's add a flanger for that. The possibilities with Stylus are endless. These effects, I think, are really killer. I mean, that's the reason why we did the guitar library to begin with, is because with these amps and effects and stuff, it's so natural for guitar. But it's really useful for drums as well. If you're looking for these trashy kinds of stuff, just throw that guitar amp on there. One thing about Stylus RMX is it couldn't be easier to do this stuff. Now, one other thing that I want to look at is the structure of how these drums are assembled. Let's load in snares, rock one. This is basically the first set of snares with the rock mix. Now, each drum is recorded with a left and right hit. That way, rolls can sound natural. I included flams for a lot of the sounds. Side sticks, all sorts of things. These left and right round robins apply with the kicks. With the rides. With the toms, with the hi-hats, side sticks, brushes. Even with tambourines, it can be pretty handy. In the manual, you'll find keyboard layouts for all the drums, so you can see how they're all mapped out. The kicks, the snares, the toms, the cymbals, whatever. So it's pretty easy. So check out our website, sampleholics.com, as well as our sister site, realitone.com. And don't forget to visit our Facebook page, where we'll be posting news, special offers, videos, demos at facebook.com/realitone.